Mr. Speaker, I'm pleased to yield 5 minutes to the gentleman from New Jersey, Mr. Ferguson. The
gentleman from New Jersey is recognized for 5 minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I rise today with mixed emotions. I'm proud of our troops and the sacrifices they've made in Iraq, their dedication, their perseverance, and the love and support of their families here at home. I'm disappointed that the strategies employed thus far have not been more successful and that our progress in Iraq has been too slow. And I'm saddened that those who have drafted this resolution are offering no alternatives of their own for our mission in Iraq. Indeed, they're prohibiting consideration in this chamber of any alternative, and therefore, I'll vote against this resolution. I believe most Americans share the same goal for Iraq, a stable government that can serve its people, a strong security force that can protect its people, and a growing economy that can encourage prosperity for its people. We want the Iraqis to succeed, and we want our troops to come home. There's no question and no denying that mistakes in the planning and execution of the war have led us to where we are today. Hindsight is 20/20, and we can all offer suggestions for how things should have been done differently, done better, done more effectively during the past 4 years. But that's not what's going on here in this chamber today. Members are being cynically asked to vote on a resolution that does not address victory or success. It does not offer a pathway toward the peace and the prosperity that are vital to the region. It simply plays politics with the war, and in so doing, does our troops and their families here at home a terrible disservice. While no one in this chamber or any general in uniform can guarantee the success of this new initiative in Iraq, we can safely say that not pursuing it and continuing the status quo will lead to failure. Iraq then likely would fall into further chaos and transform itself, much as Afghanistan did a decade ago, into a breeding ground for terrorists who plot attacks not on our troops in Iraq, but upon our civilians here at home. Make no mistake, failure of the U.S. mission in Iraq will not end the war. It will only shift the battlefield. The terrorists are at war with us, whether we fight back or not. The consequences of failure in Iraq would be as dramatic as the fruits of victory. An Iraqi government stable enough to take the lead role in providing for its own internal security will allow us to achieve our collective goal, the return home of U.S. troops. And rather than being allied with terrorists, Iraq would be an ally with America in the war on terror. And in so doing, it would honor the more than 3,000 American men and women who have died fighting for its freedom and for the countless more who have been wounded and will bear for their lifetimes the scars of battle. The status quo in Iraq is unacceptable. We need a new strategy, new tactics, new commanders on the ground, and a new and sustained commitment from the Iraqi government that they will do more of their share. We know that the road ahead will be difficult and that the prospects for success are dwindling. But I believe a renewed and amplified effort by U.S. forces and Iraqi troops to regain security in Baghdad may offer the best hope we have for the lasting success of the U.S. mission and for the future stability of Iraq's government. It may also be, I believe, our last chance for victory. The President knows this, and I believe the Iraqi government and its people know this too. It's in that spirit and with that understanding that I will vote against this resolution. Our collective prayer is for the safety of our troops, for their success, and that they will be reunited with their families here at home as soon as possible. I yield back.